What if I told you that your entire digital life, your passwords, your bank info, your private messages, could be stolen in under 30 seconds? Not by elite hackers, not through malware, not by cracking encryption, but by you, clicking a link that looks completely legit. The scariest part? You'd willingly hand over your credentials, thinking you're on the real site. By the time you realize what happened, it's already too late. Welcome to Tech Sky. Today, we're exposing phishing and social engineering, the world's most successful hacking techniques that require zero coding. You'll see how attackers build fake login pages for Instagram, Facebook, PayPal, TikTok, so real, even professionals get fooled. And more importantly, you'll learn how to spot these traps and protect yourself before it's too late. Because this isn't just about tech. It's about your identity, your money, and your peace of mind. Before we begin, I need to make something absolutely clear. Everything demonstrated in this video is strictly for educational purposes only. The knowledge you're about to gain comes with significant responsibility. Understanding these techniques is crucial for recognizing and defending against these attacks, but using these methods to actually steal credentials is not only unethical, but illegal in most jurisdictions worldwide. All our demonstrations today will be performed in a controlled laboratory environment using our own testing platforms. We will not be targeting any real individuals. Today's video is comprehensive and packed with detailed information, so grab your notebook. We're going to cover everything from setting up phishing pages to deploying them with different techniques and seeing just how convincing these attacks can be. Before we dive into the technical demonstration, let's understand what makes phishing so effective. Phishing works by exploiting human psychology rather than technical vulnerabilities. People are naturally trusting, especially when something looks familiar. We're also driven by basic desires: to gain something, to avoid losing something, or to help others. The most effective phishing attacks leverage these psychological triggers. They might offer something enticing like free followers, promise to secure your account from a non-existent threat, or even impersonate someone you trust asking for help. The technical aspect, creating a convincing fake website, is actually the easy part. The real art of phishing is in the social engineering, creating a scenario compelling enough that the victim suspends their usual caution and enters their credentials. Now, let's see how easily these attacks can be created using a tool called Zphisher. As always, we'll start by updating our Kali Linux system. Open your terminal and run sudo apt update. This command refreshes your system's knowledge of available packages and their versions. It's like checking a catalog to see what's available before actually shopping. Next, let's upgrade our system with sudo apt upgrade. When prompted, type Y to continue. This command actually installs newer versions of packages that are already on your system. Keeping your system updated is crucial for security. Now that our system is updated, let's install Zphisher. Unlike some tools, Zphisher isn't included in the default Kali repositories, so we'll need to download it from GitHub. Open your web browser and search for Zphisher. Click on the first result to open the repository. Now, we need to clone this repository to our local machine. Copy the URL either from the address bar or by clicking the green code button and copying the URL provided. Go back to your terminal and type git clone, followed by pasting the URL you just copied. Press enter to start the cloning process. Once the repository is cloned, we need to navigate into the Zphisher directory. Type cd Zphisher and press enter. Let's see what files we have by typing ls. You'll notice several files, including a bash script named zphisher.sh. This script is the main installer and launcher for the Zphisher tool. Now that we're in the Zphisher directory, let's install the tool by typing bash zphisher.sh and pressing enter. The script will start running and installing necessary dependencies, including packages like curl, PHP, and services like Cloudflare and local expos that help in creating tunnels to make your local phishing pages accessible from the internet. This installation process might take a minute or two, depending on your internet speed and whether you already have some of these dependencies installed. Once the installation is complete, you'll see the main Zphisher interface. This menu shows the various platforms that Zphisher can generate phishing pages for. The list is extensive. Everything from social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, to email services, dating apps, and even banking portals. For our first demonstration, let's try Facebook. Press 1 and hit Enter to select Facebook. Now you'll see different phishing attack options for Facebook. These include various page templates, like the traditional login page, fake security check, and even messenger-themed pages. Each is designed to create a different pretext for asking for credentials. Let's select the first option, which is the traditional login page. Press 1 and hit Enter. After this, Zphisher presents you with three methods to serve your phishing page. The first option is localhost, which makes the page available only on your local network. The second is Cloudflare, which creates a tunnel to make your page accessible from anywhere on the internet. The third is Local Expose, another tunneling service. For our first demonstration, let's use option 1, localhost, by pressing 1 and enter. Zphisher will now ask if you want to use a custom port. For simplicity, let's stick with the default by pressing N and hitting enter. The tool is now setting up the phishing page. After a moment, you'll see the localhost URL appear. To test our phishing page, place your cursor over the link, hold Ctrl, and click. This will open the link in your default web browser. Look at that. A perfect replica of the Facebook login page has opened in your browser. Everything looks identical to the real Facebook login page. The logo, the colors, the layout, even the copyright information at the bottom. If I didn't know this was a phishing page, I would have no reason to suspect it isn't legitimate. This is exactly why these attacks are so effective. Let's test the functionality by entering some credentials. I'll type techsky@email.xyz as the email and subscribe as the password, then click the login button. Notice what happens after clicking login. You're redirected to the actual Facebook website, specifically to the Find Your Account page. This is a common tactic used by phishers. By redirecting to the legitimate site, victims might think there was just a login error and try again on the real site, never realizing their credentials were just stolen. Now, let's go back to our terminal where Zphisher is running. You'll see that the credentials we just entered have been captured and displayed. In a real attack, the phisher would have these credentials and could now access the victim's account. Let's terminate this process by pressing Ctrl-C and try another example that demonstrates social engineering techniques. Let's restart Zphisher by running bash zphisher.sh again. This time, let's select Instagram by pressing 2 and hitting Enter. You'll see various attack options for Instagram. Let's choose option 3, which is the 1,000 followers template. This represents a common social engineering tactic, appealing to people's desire for popularity and status. Press 3 and hit Enter. This time, instead of using localhost, let's see how attackers would make this accessible over the internet. Zphisher is now launching Cloudflare to create a tunnel. Again, we'll skip the custom port option by pressing N. It's also asking if we want to use URL masking. For now, let's select N to skip this feature. We'll explore masking in our next example. After a moment, you'll see several links appear, including a Cloudflare link. Place your cursor over the Cloudflare link, hold Ctrl, and click to open it in your browser. Look at this page. It's designed to appeal to users who want more followers on Instagram. The page promises 1,000 free followers if you log in with your Instagram credentials. This is a classic social engineering technique, offering something desirable to trick users into providing their credentials. If you scroll down, you'll see a form asking for Instagram login information. Let me enter TechSky as the username and subscribe as the password, then click Login. Just like that, the credentials are captured in our Zphisher terminal, ready for an attacker to use. The effectiveness of this attack lies in its appeal to desire. Many people want more followers, and this fake promise might override their usual caution about entering credentials on unfamiliar sites. Let's try one more example that demonstrates URL masking, a technique phishers use to make suspicious links look legitimate. Press Ctrl-C to terminate the current process and restart Zphisher. From the main menu, let's select TikTok by pressing 10 and hitting Enter. For the port forwarding service, let's try Local Expose this time. Press 3 and hit Enter. Local Expose requires an account and access token. Open the URL provided in your browser to create an account or sign in if you already have one. Then navigate to the Access tab and copy your access token. Paste this token into the Zphisher terminal where requested and press Enter. When asked about changing the region, press N for now. Now comes the URL masking option. This time, let's select Y to enable it. URL masking allows attackers to disguise the actual phishing URL to make it look more legitimate. You'll be asked to enter a custom domain name. In a real attack, phishers would use something that mimics the targeted service. But for our demonstration, I'll enter subscribetotechsky.com to show how this works. After processing, Zphisher will display several URLs. Look at the third one. It's been masked to include the text we entered, making it look more trustworthy to potential victims. If we open this link, we'll first see a warning from the URL shortener service, and then from Local Expose. In a real attack, many users might click through these warnings, assuming they're just standard disclaimer notices. Once past the warnings, we see a page designed to trick TikTok users into entering their credentials with the promise of increasing likes. Again, this appeals to the desire for social validation. Let me enter TechSky as the username and like subscribe as the password, then click Submit. Immediately, these credentials are captured by Zphisher and displayed in our terminal, giving an attacker everything they need to take over the account. You might have noticed the warnings that appeared when using Local Expose with URL masking. These are protective measures implemented by browsers and services to warn users about potentially dangerous sites. For attackers who want to avoid these warnings, using the Cloudflare method without URL masking often results in fewer warning messages. This creates a smoother experience for victims, making them less likely to become suspicious. Now that we've seen how easy it is to create convincing phishing pages, let's talk about how to protect yourself from these attacks. Always verify the URL before entering any credentials. Look carefully at the domain name and make sure it exactly matches the official site. Phishers often use domains that look similar but have slight variations. Be suspicious of unsolicited messages with links, even if they appear to come from friends or trusted organizations. If someone sends you a link to log into a service, instead of clicking it, manually navigate to the service by typing the genuine URL in your browser. Enable two-factor authentication wherever possible. Even if your password is compromised through phishing, attackers would still need the second verification factor to access your account. Be wary of offers that seem too good to be true, like free followers, prizes, or exclusive deals. These are common lures used in phishing attacks. Use a password manager that can recognize legitimate websites. These tools will only autofill credentials on sites they recognize, providing an extra layer of protection. Keep your browser and devices updated to benefit from the latest security features that help identify and block phishing sites. Most importantly, develop a healthy skepticism when online. If something feels off or too good to be true, trust your instincts and proceed with caution. Today, we've seen just how easy it is to create convincing phishing pages that target social media accounts. From perfect replicas of login pages to social engineering techniques that prey on desires for followers and likes, these attacks are sophisticated and extremely effective. What makes phishing particularly dangerous is that it bypasses technical security measures by targeting the human element. No amount of encryption or firewalls can fully protect against a convincing social engineering attack. Remember, the knowledge shared in this video is meant to help you understand these threats and protect against them, never to cause harm. Always operate within legal and ethical boundaries. If you found this demonstration valuable for your security journey, smash that like button right now. It really helps the channel reach more people who need this critical information. And if you haven't already, hit subscribe and turn on notifications so you never miss our latest security insights. For those of you who want to support TechSky and get exclusive content, consider becoming a channel member. Share this video with your friends and family. You might be helping someone avoid becoming a victim of these attacks. The more people understand these threats, the safer we all become. I love hearing from you, so drop a comment sharing your thoughts on phishing or suggesting what security topic you'd like me to cover next. Your feedback shapes the future content of this channel, and I read every single comment. Remember, knowledge is power, but with power comes responsibility. Until next time, stay curious, stay ethical, and keep learning. This is TechSky, signing off.
Watching the ice, 做进了我